Hello, dear friends and subscribers of Cricket Happenings. Welcome to your usual edition of the Cricket Happenings with the World Cup summaries here. Well, yesterday we had a match where Bangladesh and Afghanistan played at Canberra, and Bangladesh started off the World Cup in fine fashion when they actually won the match by 105 runs against the debutants Afghanistan. As you know, Afghanistan was playing their first World Cup match, and that resulted in Bangladesh winning the match and Afghanistan actually losing the match by 105 runs. But other than Afghanistan did pretty well, but Bangladesh would be very happy because if you look at the margin of victory, it was good. Well, it was a very huge crowd that had actually assembled there at Canberra, even though it's a small place at the Manuka Oval. Manuka Oval, as we all know, that the always the curtain raiser whenever any touring team actually comes to Australia, the first thing is the playing the Prime Minister's 11 in the Manuka Oval in Canberra. And Manuka Oval saw this match, which was a very very good match in the sense it was lots of runs coming in, and Bangladesh were the ones who were all out for 267. In fact, Bangladesh were the ones who actually won the toss. And Mashraf Ahmed was elected to bat. As I said, Bangladesh had a lot of crowd support. Afghanistan too had some crowd support, being their first match in the World Cup 2015, and also their first World Cup match in their entire international history. And that was a proud moment for Mohammad Nabi when he actually went on to toss the coin along with Mashraf Ahmed. It was a significant moment. And Bangladesh, you know, there were a lot of support for the Bangladeshi. I thought, even though Afghanistan's were there, Afghanistani fans were there, I thought the Bangladeshi fans were outnumbering them. And the atmosphere was absolutely superb. There was a lot of sounds, a lot of egging on the players, and we all saw that. And well, as I said, Mashraf and Murtaza winning the toss without any hesitation decided to bat first. And it was a very watchful opening session, one could say, between with the openers Anamul Haq and Tamim Iqbal. Pretty circumspect when they were playing. Hamid Hassan was sometimes getting the ball to really rear up with the bounce. Shapur Zadran was very, very impressive with his bowling, his left-arm pace bowling. I was very happy to see Shapur Zadran because, as you know, in the previous match, he didn't play. It was very good to see Shapur Zadran into action. Well, it all started with Anamul Haq and Tamim Iqbal. Really watchful. Anamul Haq was showing some good technique against the pace bowlers Hamid Hassan and Shapur Zadran. Tamim Iqbal was taking his time. As you know, no longer Tamim Iqbal is a dasher. He likes to take his time at the crease, and that's besides reason in this year. He has already notched up, off late, he has notched up 2 centuries, which was not there at all on his career graph before. But finally, Tamim Iqbal biding his time. But whenever he used to stroke the ball was stroked pretty sweetly and in a very, very powerful manner. Anamul Haq was looking good, and both of them, but also I thought Shapur Zadran was also bowling in the right areas, not giving much to the batsman to really score off. It was pretty good to know, and Anamul Haq and Tamim Iqbal put on a good partnership, a decent partnership of 47 runs, as runs were not easy to come by, and I thought the Bangladeshi bowlers were bowling well. Aftab Alam was pressed into action. Then Mirwais Ashraf was very, very economical. In fact, he was the pick of the bowlers yesterday, as I would say. And Anamul Haq and Tamim Iqbal went about their business, and when they put on 47 for the first wicket, Mirwais Ashraf coming into the attack was bowling economically, was not really giving anything in the scoring areas, and that really frustrated the Bangladeshis, and it resulted in the first breakthrough as far as Afghanistan was concerned, as Afghanistan picked up their first wicket of the Bangladeshis as they stopped the opening stand of 47 between Anamul Haq and Tamim Iqbal. When the first wicket was taken by Mirwais Ashraf, as Tamim Iqbal gave a catch to Afsar Zazai, who was actually playing the Afghanistan team in place of Usman Ghani, 18-year-old baby of the team. But I was a bit surprised at that selection there. But Tamim Iqbal was the first to go, caught Afsar Zazai, bowled Mirwais Ashraf for 19 of 42 balls, 2 fours. And then Anamul Haq, after doing a good job of scoring 29 of 55 balls with 4 fours, as always happens, Once Tamim Iqbal was out, Anamul Haq was also sent back to the pavilion, with Mirwais Ashraf really doing a very, very good job as he picked up Anamul Haq LBW for 29, and that left Bangladesh at 52 for 2. After that, Soumya Sarkar came in and joined Mehmudullah. And Soumya Sarkar, in one particular over, He went on to hit three fours in a single over, but Shapur Zadran took his wicket. So Soumya Sarkar coming to the World Cup, making his debut, one could say, in the World Cup, and he was gone. Shapur Zadran finally got his reward after some very, very good bowling, incisive bowling, one could say. He picked up the wicket of Soumya Sarkar, LBW, for 28 of 25 balls with three fours and 1 6. Mahmudullah was joined in by Shakib Al Hasan. The score at 102 for 3 at the halfway mark, and thought Afghanistan bowlers were doing a good job. After that, Mahmudullah, well, I couldn't score any boundaries. He was kept to 23 of 46 balls, and then Shapur Zadran, in his second spell, picked up the wicket of Mahmudullah by getting him caught by Afsar Zazai behind the wickets. So he was gone for 23, and the score at 119 for 4 when Mahmudullah departed. And then, after that, it really required someone to really stay and play a very, very sizable knock, and that came in the form of Mushfiqur Rahim along with Shakib Al Hasan. Both really first, you know, the score was really 119 for 4 when they entered the scene, and they had to really, really do a bit of resurrection, which they did it. And finally, when they had done it, we really saw some beautiful strokes flowing from the blade of Shakib Al Hasan and Mushfiqur Rahim as they really started playing some very, very good strokes, and slowly the partnership started blossoming, and Bangladesh suddenly were looking pretty strong as the opening, as this fifth wicket partnership yielded almost 114 runs in some fine fashion. And finally, when the partnership was really, really doing well, and in fact Bangladesh, both the batsmen had done their job of taking the score to 233 in the 45th over. That was the time when probably the acceleration was required at the batting power play. Shakib Al Hasan, Mushfiqur Rahim went after the Afghanistan bowlers and really racked a lot of runs. And finally, the fifth wicket fell when this partnership was broken by Hamid Hassan, the pace bowler, as he picked up by clean bowling Shakib Al Hasan for 63 of 51 balls with 6 fours and 1 6. And after that, it was Sabir Rahman. And after that, in fact, what Afghanistan did is they picked up some quick wickets. Sabir Rahman was bowled by Hamid Hassan for 3. And then Mushfiqur Rahim, after doing a wonderful job of scoring 71 of 56 balls at 6 fours and 1 6, was a goner as Mohammad Nabi, the Red Armour spinner, picked him up as Mushfiqur Rahim was caught in the deep by Samir Lashain Wari. And after that, as I said, it was quick work, barring Mashraf Murtaza, the captain, who scored 14 of 9 balls with 3 fours before being clean bowled by Aftab Alam. Mominul Haq, I was a bit surprised at the what happened. The reason being, Mominul Haq is such a talented player, loves actually playing his strokes, and let me tell you, I was really, really surprised. Whether it was injury, one does not know. And Mominul Haq is such a player who comes at the top of the order, probably due to injury. He came very low down the order, and well, he was run out for 3. So that really, really puzzles me, as I said, unless and until I think that if at all Mominul Haq was injured, that was okay. But you know, Mominul Haq normally plays on the top of the order, so I was a bit surprised at that slotting that was done. As far as it was not a slotting which was done deliberately, I think that's a good move. Well, Rubel Hossain was not out on not. Taskin Ahmed was bowled by Alam for 1, and the Bangladeshi innings finally wound up at 260-some, but they played the whole 50 overs, and they were 267 all out. Looking at the Afghanistani bowling in their demo match in the World Cup here in 2015, Hamid Hassan, I thought, was costly. 10 overs, 2 for 61, he could have bowled a better line than that, but Shapur Zadran really, really stood out. Splendid bowling. He was, with his height and the bombs that he was generating, it was not easy for the batsman. And again, another surprise here from the Afghanistanis, I thought, because Shapur Zadran was the, even though Mirwais Ashraf was the pick of the bowlers, I thought Shapur Zadran did a wonderful job. The left-arm pace bowler, tall, gangling, his hair locks really, really flying in the air when he's actually bowling. It's a good sight to watch young fast bowlers having such dreadlocks and bowling in nice fashion. He has a good action too. And Shapur Zadran, well, I was a bit surprised there with Shapur Zadran, because I thought Mohammad Nabi should have actually used him for his entire quota. He finished up bowling 7 overs, 1 maiden, 2 for 20. And I'm sure Mohammad Nabi will really look into this and in the subsequent matches use Shapur Zadran to the maximum. Aftab Alam, 9 overs, 2 for 55. But Mirwais Ashraf was the one who really picked up the wickets, especially picking up both the openers and really giving Afghanistan a real foot in the door there. Mirwaz Ashraf, 9 overs, 3 minutes, 32 runs and 2 wickets. He bowls wicket to wicket and he was pretty impressive. Mohammad Nabi, 9 overs, 1 for 58. Javed Ahmadi, 4.5 overs, no maiden, none for 32. And Samir Lashainwari bowled 1.1 over, no maiden, none for 2. Let's have a look at the Afghanistan innings. So Afghanistan, for the first time in the World Cup, getting into the batting arena there and actually chasing this total of 261, which was a very good total on this pitch, but definitely possible because, as I said, it was a good batting pitch to bat on. And well, it all started with Afghanistan opening with Javed Ahmadi and the wicketkeeper Afzal Zazai. But well, let me tell you, Mashraf and Murtaza really, really rocked them pretty early on in the innings. First, he picked up in the very first over of the final delivery. He sent Javed Ahmadi back to the pavilion when Javed Ahmadi gave a return catch back to Mashraf and Murtaza for one of two balls. So that made it 2 for 1. And it soon became 2 for 2. The other opener, Afzal Zazai, being claimed by Rubel Hussain. Rubel Hussain, normally one does not see Rubel Hussain bowl well, but I thought yesterday he bowled very well. And he clean bowled Afzal Zazai for one. And Afghanistan definitely not having the best of starts here. And they were struggling at 2 for 2. And Mustafa Murtaza then picked up Askar Stanikza. Now, Askar Stanikza is the very main batsman of Afghanistan. And he was sent back to the pavilion pretty early in the piece by Mashraf and Murtaza, as Murtaza actually got him caught by Mahmudullah for one, and Afghanistan innings was really, really slipping away at 3 for 3 in the third over. Nawroz Mangal, the former Afghanistani captain, was along with Samiullah Shainwari, and both of them slowly tried to stem the tide. What they did is they took the score on to 65, so it's a 62 run partnership. And then Mahmudullah came in and dismissed Nawroz Mangal for 27 of 57 balls with 1-4. After that, the score read 65 for 4. And then Samiullah Shainwari fell as soon as Nawroz Mangal was out, as both of them had to really, really be very, very cautious. They couldn't really take any chances. Before they could even try to get some strokes going, it was very unfortunate to see Samiullah Shainwari with a misunderstanding getting run out for 42 of 75 balls with 2-4s, which made it 65 for 4 in the 23rd over. And after that, so 78 for 5 in the 26th over. And then there was another partnership. Now, this was a partnership between Najibullah Zadran I thought it was Mohammad Nabi. The captain was there. And Mohammad Nabi played some very nice strokes, but again, the support was lacking from the other end. Najibullah Zadran tried his bit, making 17 of 34 balls with 1-4, but he was a victim of the bowling of Shakib Al Hasan. And then we saw some, definitely saw some big hitting from the lower order there, but that was not enough. And Mohammad Nabi realized that it was he who has to actually, the onus was on him, if at all Afghanistan had to win. But Mohammad Nabi himself succumbed as Mashraf Murtaza, coming on for his second spell, dismissed his opposite number, his captain, the captain of Afghanistan team, caught by Soumya Sarkar for 44 or 43 balls with 5-4s. Mashraf Ashraf went on after that. As I said, the Afghanistan batting lower order started swinging the bats wildly, just to see if at all it connects. They could really push the Bangladeshis. But was not enough, really. Mirwaz Ashraf fell, doing that out for 10 of 15 balls with 1-6 to the bowling of Shakib Al Hasan. Aftab Alam was run off for 14 of 12 balls with 2-4s and 1-6. He was pretty aggressive, 14 of 12 balls. Hamid Hasan fell for naught. Shapur Zadran was not out on 2. And the Afghanistan innings never looked like winning this match, as they were all out for 162. Thus, Bangladesh winning their first match of the World Cup 2015 and starting it off in a nice way, with a win by 105 runs over Afghanistan at Manuka Oval in Canberra. The bowling, well, the bowling, I've been asked to say that I have to really credit the Bangladeshis for some very, very disciplined bowling. And it was good to see that the Bangladeshi bowlers really stuck to a very good line. The bowling was pretty good. Mashraf and Murtaza, the captain himself, setting a huge example. 9 overs, 2 maidens, 20 runs and 3 wickets in his bag. Rubel Hussain, I thought, bowled very well. It was very good to see that Rubel Hussain is slowly getting his bearings right. 6 overs, no maiden, 1 for 27. Task in Ahmed, that was really looking pretty pacey. 7 overs, 1 minute, none for 23, looked promising. Shakib El Hasan, 8.5 overs, no made in 2 for 43. Mahmoud Al Haider was 1 minute, 1 for 31. 3 overs for 13 for Soumya Sarkar. Sabir Rahman bowling 1 over for 4 runs. And Mushfiqur Rahim of Bangladesh was named man of the match. I thought it was a very, very good effort from Bangladesh. And they were well supported, first by the batsmen, and then the bowlers really, really supported the score that Bangladesh did. And it was very good to see. So Bangladesh have started off on the right note here in the World Cup 2015. Well, today's match which is coming up is going to see United Arab Emirates playing their first match in World Cup 2015. And they are playing their, as you remember, in 1996 they made the debut in the World Cup. After that, they couldn't really make it to the World Cup. And finally, after a gap of 20 years, United Arab Emirates are playing their they are coming back into the World Cup, and that would be a proud moment for them when they take on Zimbabwe. As you know, Zimbabwe are looking very strong this year in this World Cup 2015, as they already had some big names scalped in the warm-ups, and they also gave a very good fighting. They really gave a fighting performance against South Africa. So it should be a very good game which is coming up today between United Arab Emirates in Zimbabwe, and I'll be there with a full match report tomorrow on this particular match. Until then, it is your host Ram signing off for the day. Thank you.